Alright, welcome to another video. But first, Happy New Year to you, and that 2023 is going to be the greatest year for all of us. And this time we're going to light a scene for its movement. So we're going to take an Oscar-nominated actor, me, don't take it too serious, my acting skills are none, you can't even call it skills. So this time I just want to show you that you can light the environment so the subject can move inside and you don't have to rearrange all the lightings to get the perfect lighting on your subject all the time. Because when you're on a budget, doesn't always mean you don't have you just don't have the money for a good camera or something. You also don't have the time to rearrange everything. And to make it a real challenge, we light the scene with just two video focused lights. So one is lighting the outside and one is my key light. And all the lights you see inside the frame are just there to either light my background or to justify my way of lighting, especially the key light. So that's all the FYI, and let's dive into the scene. So this scene is just an addition to the bathroom scene that I filmed two videos ago, and it is inspired by the movie Prisoners with the cinematographer Roger Deakins and the director Denis Villeneuve. Great movie, just watch it, you will love it. This sets the mood for the scene. So let's get into the camera setup. I used the Sigma 24-70 on its f2.8, so the fastest that this lens can go, and the Sony A7IV. White balance is to 3600, so 3600 Kelvin. To match a little bit more with the ambient light, the practicals that you can see. And yeah, that's it. Yeah, and everything was shot on a tripod. Now let's get into the scene setup itself, the lighting setup. But to the screen right, you see a practical light that was the Aperture B7C. I had to use it to adjust the light a little bit because this light was a little bit too orange. And that's why I set the bulb to around 4200 Kelvin to compensate the bounce back, the orange tone bounce back from the cabinet, that this side's not too orange and looking weird. And the left side, between the window and the couch, that's just a normal bulb you can find everywhere. And my key light is actually the light you see here. It's the Falcon Eye, the flexible LED panel. It's great. I set it to 3200, so my white balance on the camera 3600, the LED panel was 3200, so it gives me a warm tone that matches the 3200 bulb light you see to my left, or screen you see to the screen left. Actually, what the other thing that lights the room is my shirt. I choose the white shirt on purpose. If you look at the black book in front of me, you see that it catches the reflection of my shirt, and this adds a little bit more to the foreground, so it's more visible but not distracting. And finally, the outside is lit by my new favorite light, the anglerfish from iFootage, the SL1 320DN. Amazing for the buck. So if you can afford it, go ahead. It's great. And because it's daylight and the camera white balance is set so low, it gives it this bluish look. And this is actually the only light that I changed something on. So all the time I'm in the frame, the main subject, I had this parabolic softbox on it and switched it for the standard reflector that comes with it. Then I wrapped a little bit of aluminium foil around it to give it more of a spotlight for the book close-ups, you see. And for additional diffusion, I just used the curves that were already hanging there, so I avoid having hot spots on my face. And that's the lighting setup for the whole scene. I never had to touch it, never had to move it, and I was able to move around. But what's the main point you gotta have in mind when you light for an environment? You always have to see the layers of your frame. You have the foreground, you have the space where the subject is always in focus, and you have a background. Those are the three main areas you have to light. And as you can see in this scene, it's not just the actor that is moving around, it's also different camera angles. And in all camera angles, there's always something in those areas. There are either body parts in the foreground, or you see the book, the bottle, and the background always acts like a frame. Then you got the God's eye angle. There I'm lit by the background light. You see there's my side catches a little bit from the light. The key light still hits my forearm, so this acts a little bit like a foreground. You see the bluish that my shirt catches from the outside. You still get this natural teal and orange look. And the next scene, there you see there's the window, the bluish window. And with my head being in the darkness, that just serves the whole story. So if you watched Prisoners, just remember that Detective Loki is desperately searching for a little kid that is kidnapped. Here you see that the light is pointing towards my face, so you're leading the viewer's attention towards the subject, even though it's not the brightest part. But then here I'm coming back into the light being the brightest part, so sometimes you gotta break the rules to serve the story. And if you look at this close-up, you see that everything that's in front of the actor's face is lit, and everything behind him, behind the actor, is dark. So this also serves the story. You see that the actor is taking the book and swipes the pages and sees that there's something in it. So there's light in front of him, and the darkness gets more and more into the background. And then there's finally the scene where the clue's popping up. And that's also when I decided to switch from the softbox to the regular reflector to get more harsh light into it. And then you get this dark, bright, dark kind of leading lines towards the clue. You see, it's just that simple to light on a budget and still be able to light with purpose. All right, that's it for today. I hope it was interesting, and please forgive me my acting skills, and I hope to see you in the next one. Peace.